Addressing a media conference, Nipangelwa says reports in the local newspapers are untrue, pointing out that businesses are still doing fine, despite the closure of some foreign-owned businesses in the past years. Several foreign companies closed down at the town due to low buying power of Angolan nationals.
We have so many shops or even complex which opened at the time of the economy when it was collapsed already. And I can mention them. We have companies like Woolman Brook. The time they came here, they came when the economy was already down. And they have expanded their branches. They open with one shop first, and then they add another shop. Not only them. There is a complex where ShopRite is operating from. That complex, the time they open at the time when the economy was already down. Businesses that are doing export, yes, they are not doing well, simply because the Angolan, when they are coming here, they have to buy with USA dollar. And as we know, in Angola, USA dollar are very small now.
However, the closure of foreign businesses saw many local businesses coming in, and this has revived the economy in the town again.
I have been in Oshikango from that time, 1997, up to now. And I have been seeing Oshikango, how it is growing. Therefore, I am confident, and I know it is true, it will never die. And based on what we did, and we see the result, and we know things that are in pipeline, which will be completed and add to what we have already done, that will increase the buying power.
Unifood Southern African Northern Area Manager Pete Muller says 2 years ago his business made a loss of about $1 million per year. However, since last year, business has started to pick up, although not to their expectations, because expenses are high, spending $140,000 in electricity and rental fees every month. Muller has been trading at Oshikango for 10 years after relocating to Oshakati. He says cross-border trading at Oshakati has negatively affected business, as he used to export trucks of frozen fish and chicken, but this is no longer the case.
I cannot see that we can survive for the next 2-3 years if it's going on like that. I'm telling you, it's very, very bad. I don't know what we can do. I said from Angola side, maybe that will help us. Because it's a border town. And a border town had a lot of things across border, cross border, and sales and that type of things. So yes, when in Angola will become better, I think Oshikango will also become much better. But really, we suffer now.